morning, everybody. It is Bank Holiday Monday, which means this morning myself and Alfie watched a lot of Wallace and Gromit, and it doesn't mean that. That's not what Bank Holiday means, but that's what we've done today. I forgot how much I freaking love Wallace and Gromit, especially like the old ones. They're just amazing. So that's what we did this morning. We were also woken up to really loud thunder and lightning and really heavy rain, and I actually quite liked it. I'm one of those people that quite likes the setting on the Relax app that's rain. So that was actually quite nice to wake up to. I quite enjoyed that. As long as you don't have to go out in it, I feel like rain outside is such a cozy thing. I also have this little nugget here. Hello, little nugget, who is obsessed with this squirrel, which is what Anna bought. Anna bought like a little, when Nala was a puppy, she bought like a little, I don't really know what to call it, like
a, it was a tree stump.
It was a little tree stump, wasn't it? And it had three of these in. And it was kind of like a,
it was like a family of squirrels.
There's three of these basically, and you put them in there and the dog pulls them out. But Nala doesn't have the brain skills to pull them out. So we got rid of the tree stump and she just likes the squirrels. But they are her favourite, so thanks, Anna. She's loved them since day one. This one in particular goes everywhere with her. Look at his hair! Alvin, Simon and Theodore, the chipmunks. Anyway, that's Nala's favourite squirrel. And it was a gift from Anna when she was a puppy. What are you watching? What's that, Nala? Is that a pug that's too hot? Oh, they put a little cold flannel on his head. This is my life. Oh my god, why is she so cute right now? I love when she looks up, when her head's down, but she looks up. It's like sad pug face. She's really tired. She's even let go of, I'm gonna call this one Alvin. Oh, no. No. Sorry, Nala. Okay, you can go back to sleep now. God. I tried to get him. I tried. Nope, she is obsessed / attached.
She thinks it's her baby.
I think she does think it's her baby. Look how she holds it. She like proper holds it with her paws. Nala, you've styled that hair a lot. I think the hair's done now. That you can stop sucking on the hair. Guys, this is the struggle we have when we try and crate Nala before we leave.
Nala, come.
She knows.
Come.
She knows. She's like,
Watch this.
We're supposed to be leaving now, but she's like, this is like a game for her. She's like, you can't catch me. I'm not going in the crate. I want to come with you.
Hey. That's nice. Hello.
You're not going to be able to.
Hello. That's nice.
Come on then.
Good girl. Oh, you're coming down. Yeah, you're coming down.
Okay. We got her. We are now off to Stanmer House, which we've been to many times, as you guys have seen, normally in the garden on a sunny day, but it's definitely not a sunny day today, so I'm guessing we're inside. And it's to celebrate Alfie's dad's birthday. So I'm very excited. Here's my little present. I got him a candle, and Alfie bought him
some shoes.
Tattoos. And, oh, you forgot to wrap the tattoos.
No, I'm about to do it now.
Oh, you're wrapping. You should have just put those in there.
No, I realised.
What a waste of paper.
And we got him a suit as well.
A masseuse?
A suit.
Oh, a suit. So you're like, and we've got a masseuse as well. I was like, have we? So yes, we're about to head off. I think it's going to be a really lovely lunch. Your grandma's coming as well, isn't she?
Is she?
Yeah, I think
so. I literally was about to say to you earlier, I haven't seen my grandma in like a couple of weeks.
Yeah, she's coming. She's coming. Cool. So instead of wearing a coat, I've just gone for a jumper over the top. Because it's not actually that cold, it's more just windy. So I thought that would be Very nice. I feel very preppy today with my little, you can't really see my mustard skirt. There it is. OOTD! See the shadows long beneath the mountains out. I'm not afraid. You light the way. You light the way. I got a lot deep when I got to lie. I look around me, sweet legs. We're here!
Blooming out!
Look how beautiful this place is.
Look how many cows there are.
There's loads of little cows. I love Stanmer. Do you remember we filmed my autumn lookbook here?
I did, up in there.
Up there, up in that.
Yeah.
I'm so hungry for lunch. I hope they've got that sausage and mash, not gonna lie.
Oh yeah, do you remember when I got that last time? Yeah, fucking Sean and I, look.
Where? Oh yeah, look at her.
They're all like,
oh my god. So Alfie's got a live count of my YouTube subscribers. What's it on now?
991. 997.
Seven. Oh my god, I can't. I feel sick. I literally feel sick.
Yo, this is exactly 9 million.
Yeah. I don't think we've ever seen it online.
Yeah.
I bet it's gonna go down now.
So crazy.
Oh no, it's gone up loads.
Yeah.
How exciting. That's a lot of people.
That's a hell of a
lot. It's pudding time. And celebratory pudding. This is what I went for. It's the white chocolate creme brulee with some little chocolate biscuits. Look at Poppy's. Is that sorbet?
Mm-hmm. I think it's literally just chocolate, like thick. Chocolate.
Is it like a mousse?
That's not.
No,
look, Sean's got some like little earplugs down there.
I got some
there.
Funny weird thing.
Is it nice?
Yeah, like, weird jelly sweets.
Eat it, Pop. You just
got, orange
no. Is it nice?
What's the jelly?
Alfie has gone. He's gone to Lincoln for a book signing, but myself, Poppy and Sean are still at my house. We're going for a walk. Oh,
you're
going for a walk! Nala, do you want to go for a walk? Sean, Sean, Poppy, do you want to go for a walk? She's like, oh my god, you guys are mental.
Yay!
She's going to go stand by the front door now. But yes, wow, we had the TV on really loud.
Nala, let's go!
Aww. You excited? Nana, Sean's excited.
So excited.
We're gonna go see Buzz.
Yeah, we're gonna see Buzz.
Buzz.
We probably shouldn't be hyping her up because she literally will have a heart attack. This is what Nala does when we get to the park and we don't get out straight away. Oh! Oh my goodness! She's like, I wanna be where the people are.
It's been like 5 seconds.
I wanna see. I wanna see him dancing!
Oh, Nala!
She's so annoying! We're just waiting! I know that our dog behaviourist lady would not let Nala out if she was being like this. Calm down!
I've never heard her do that noise.
I guess it's like the same as if we pulled up with a toddler next to a children's play park, yeah, and we good. Said, you can't get out yet.
Yeah.
Her eyes look so brown. Uh-oh. Nala! He's a big doggy. She's not quite sure. You cheeky little madam! So we are in the park now, letting them have a little run around. We've got them on the long leads because I trust the long lead. I don't trust the letting go of it. Sometimes she's really good at recall, but today she's being a bit mischievous, and I think it's because she's having a massive run around. Uh-oh. It's like Cat's Cradle.
Wait, who's am I in?
Oh!
Sorry, you
Now.
Yeah. Sean are trying to pick a DVD to watch.
Emphasis on trying.
So far, we think we might want to watch The Theory of Everything and something else, but we don't know. This is my DVD collection, by the way. I always think DVDs look so messy. Do you know what I mean? I might put them all into one of those, like, flip book things.
Oh, what? Just take it all out of the boxes?
Yeah.
I like looking through the boxes.
Do you?
Yeah, because then you can look at the pictures and...
It's like, oh look, I've got little pictures.
Oh look, look at it.
Or maybe we should watch a really scary film. You're right there, Pop.
I was hiding from Nala.
Pop, what do you think?
What about Honey, I Shrunk the Kids? The Grinch? Home Alone?
No,
Elf?
We're not watching The Grinch.
What have we got?
Why not?
We both wanted to watch this. Yeah.
Theory of Everything?
But then it's like, do we
want sad?
I wanted to watch Paul, but Zoe's already watched it.
I have watched Paul quite recently.
I do want to see that, but it's just
should we watch this? Should we watch The Human Centipede?
No,
I've never seen that, you know. 500 Days of Summer's pretty good.
Yeah, that's good.
I've never seen When Harry Met Sally.
I can't
when
remember.
Harry Met Sally.
When Harry Met Sally. Silly.
Harry Met Silly Sally.
When he met Silly Sally and it was
I think
was
we should
silly.
Go for this because you said that you want to watch this.
Yeah.
Okay.
That looks sick. Or A Bug's Life. Slightly different. Yeah, let's go for The Theory of Everything. Let's go a bit more deep.
Let's try it.
For our evening viewing.
We've
also ordered a little bit of food. These guys have gone for Pizza Face. Oh, I actually haven't ordered Pizza Face. Marley and Me is the saddest film I've ever seen in my life.
I cried at it in the cinema.
I cried, not only in the cinema, but all the way home. Before I owned a dog. When I'd never had a dog before.
Let's do this.
That was a fun time. In fact, I've never cried so hard at a film ever in my life.
Really?
As I have to that film, yeah.
I feel like I'd see it in another light now.
Now that you've got a dog? Mm. Yeah,
just
I reckon.
I was like, when's the dog gonna die? We all know he's gonna die.
Sean was like,
literally, Sean was like, wah. Yeah. Like, what is happening?
Oh, someone's at the door. So we decided to go for The Theory of Everything, which has just started. And the guys have got their pizza, which came in like record speed. Is it good?
It's so good.
Pizza, I swear, like we are Pizza Face's top customers.
That's
great. I basically order it every week. Girl power. So Poppy and Sean have gone home now. This spot is colossal. And I feel like through the film it was getting bigger and bigger and like throbbing, you know when a spot does that. Ew. Theory of Everything was amazing, so incredibly sad. Oh my god, there were so many times in that film where I was trying not to cry, but it was really sad and also really amazing. What an incredible man Stephen Hawking is. 9 million subscribers. It's literally like the most surreal thing. I can't quite get my head around it. And I even said this at 5 million. Any amount of subscribers that I gain, it doesn't ever sink in, ever. A lot of people ask me when it first kind of hit me that my channel was big and that it was successful and that, and honestly, sometimes it still hasn't really resonated. Like, it still doesn't really quite sit in my mind. It's just crazy to me because I started this as a hobby, not even knowing where YouTube could go. I didn't even know you could get like a million subscribers. It's just really, really amazing that there are so many of you that watch my videos, just little me, living my life, doing all these cool and crazy things and being given these amazing opportunities all because you wanted to hit subscribe and watch my videos. And I say this a lot, but I hope you really, really know how much I mean this when I say I am eternally grateful for all of you that tweet me, comment, like the videos, meet me at my book signings, buy the books, like, or just want to be involved with me on this journey. Like, that to me is like nothing that could ever be replaced by anything. That to me is like the best feeling ever, just to know that you have those people that want to support you and want to watch your videos and want to be a part of your life. And that is just incredible, because I definitely didn't ever think this would happen. I started this as a hobby 5-6 years ago, and now this is my job and this is what I do. And I always say to people, since I got my first Google check of $60, I was like, this is what I want to do. And since then, I feel like I haven't worked a day. Like, I feel like I've not worked a day, because I enjoy this so much. This isn't work to me. This is still the hobby. This is still my hobby that I started in 2009. And yes, there have been some really cool things like books and products and a freaking Madame Tussauds wax figure. But at the end of the day, those are just things that I know I'm gonna cherish when I'm old. And it's amazing to have those little accomplishments and all the things that little Zoe would have absolutely loved to do. But it is still my hobby, and it just so happens to pay my bills and allow me to live the life I live, which I don't think I will ever quite get my head around. And I still get to make the videos that I enjoyed making in 2009. I don't know why you love my videos so much. They're not high quality, they don't have big production teams behind them, they're not the videos I envisage in my head when they come out, but I enjoy them, and I'm so glad that you do as well. And yeah, just thank you. Thank you to all of you. Thank you to you watching this, for making my dreams come true and for following me and my dreams. That sounded like something from Disney. Also, never give up. I went through a really hard time at the end of last year and the start of this year, and I very nearly didn't make a video again. And it's not something I've spoken about, because I'm trying to move on. And recently I've been so much happier, and I think a lot of you can tell. There is a large part of making videos that has to be because I want to do it, and I always want to do it, always. I love it so much, and my happiness is also a massive part of it. But when I was contemplating whether or not I wanted to carry on when things got a bit hard, I was like, no. Like, I have so many people that support my channel and love the content I make and just like me for me. I just kind of pictured all your little faces, and I was like, no, I can't not do this, you know? So yeah, I'm really happy, and I love you guys so much, more than you will ever realize. So whether you subscribed right at the start or you've just subscribed, thank you very much. Really, really thank you. Cool, well, that was my little ramble, my little 10-minute ramble. 9 million. Every time I hit 1 million, I'm like, that's it now. That's gonna stop. It doesn't. You guys are amazing. I honestly think I have the best viewers. You're all so supportive, not only of me, but I watch how you are with other people, and it just makes me so proud. I feel like a proud mother slash sister slash best friend, because you're all so polite, you're all so positive and uplifting, and that's not just to me, but that's to other people. And it honestly, that is one thing that really, really makes me so happy, is how lovely my viewers are. You're just the best. the best ever. And thank you. Like, I love seeing when you guys interact with each other, when someone might send me a tweet that I've missed about, you know, some tips for anxiety or I'm having a tough time in school. Someone else will always answer it and say, hey, I'm here to chat. Send me a DM. Like, it's just the nicest community of people. And I am so grateful for those of you who go out of your way to just be lovely to other viewers. I just think that is the way forward. Positivity all the way. And just using your voice for good. I like it. I like it a lot. Thank you. Anyway, I'm getting very gushy, so I'm gonna go now. And I'm gonna leave you with Alvin, who literally looks rank. Look at the hair on that. That is just rank. Night night, guys.